We want to know what? That's okay. That's okay.
It's Pembest Dead, baby! Let's go! Are you guys hyped for this video? I'm so hyped. I want to go to Locals. I want to go to Locals right now. I just want to see my pencil cards. I want to look at them. I want to feel them. I want to put them in new sleeves. And I want OTK with them. So today's video, I'm going to Locals for the first time since pre-COVID. And I'm going to build my pendulum deck from scratch. I don't even own a Celine. Stay tuned to the end of the video. I'm going to go hop on Dueling Book right now. And I'm going to clap every noob in my path for the next few hours. Just to get an idea and feel of the deck I want to build. And then I'm going to head out to Locals and rebuild this deck from scratch. I'm going to find every card I need if it's the last thing I do. So if you're new to the channel, smash the subscribe button. If you're hyped for the best deck in the planet, smash the subscribe button and stay tuned to the end of the video. I'm going to cop some moves right now, then I'm going to go straight to Locals. We'll see you guys then. Let's go. Everyone has a hobby, you know. My hobby is going on Dueling Book and putting up 19 negates against every single player on here. Pro, nub, doesn't matter. Everyone can catch these hands. And it's a great way here, my Endymion Turbo list, to get a feel of the type of deck I want to build. Do I want to go with my typical Endymion Turbo, so I use your Pencil in 10, have a bunch of fun? Well, at least fun for me, not for my opponent. But that's all good, because Pembest deck. Here we're going to face some Rock player. And again, look at this. Sphere Mode Dark Ruler. Rocks suck, bro. Pendulums can deal with all side cards in the game. Restage, etc. Dark Ruler, good game. Later. I mean, there's 10,000 cards you can do against Rocks. Anyways, what I'm trying to get at here, I want to get an idea of how does my side deck work against the meta? How does my Turbo list work against the meta before I buy them in real life? Now, I already know they're amazing because I destroy people online every single day. Obviously, I'd play it in real life, except there's no events, so there's no point. So I just haven't gone across to build it. So as I said in the beginning of this video, this whole video, I'm going to be rebuilding this from scratch. Stupid card for stupid player, you just got to wreck. Salty. That's what pendulums do, bro. You just wreck your opponent. I love it. Now it's time to get my opponent salty in real life by destroying them with and doing it in real life. So like I said, the whole point of this whole video is just to rebuild it in real life. Almost done all the duels here. I'm just going to destroy this Eldritch. Invoked player absolutely easily. Wow is right. I OTK him. We're gonna cop one more guy here and we're gonna go straight. I had enough of Dueling Book. Time to play in real life. You guys are gonna be in for a treat right now. I'm gonna organize every single one of my Yu-Gi-Oh cards right. Oh, look at that playmat. Oh, good god. I'm gonna organize all of my cards right now live for you guys super quick. Look at that playmat, baby. The greatest playmats of all time. You get yours. These are actually not even on the site. So if you guys want those, I just showed the Joker one, the Silver one. Message me on Facebook. I'll hook you guys up. Toon Electromite right there. I'm going to be rebuilding all these cards. As you guys see here, just a bunch of random pendulum cards that could go into my deck. Organizing it. This is the deck I want to build. So I just want to see which cards I actually own. After organizing them all, I realized that I own currently these cards. But I'm still missing a good amount for the deck I want to build. So I'm still missing these cards. So I'm going to go to Locals right now to get these. And you know what? This is a lot of resleeving going on and stuff. Sounds like a lot of tedious work. So I'm going to go call my girlfriend so she can go do it for me. And I'm going to try and tell her, yo, come build a deck with me. It'll be cute or some girly shit like that. But just so she can resleeve all my cards. It'll be super clutch. Let's go see what she says.
Cuddle me.
Cuddles? Mm-hmm. We could build a deck together.
No.
Why?
Because Penn isn't best deck.
Man, first we get Droll and now this. We taking L's all day. We got most of the cards organized. We know exactly what we need to get. None of them, no more diddle daddling. Kind of lazy to go to Locals, but let's get it. We're going to go straight to Locals right now and rebuild the greatest deck of all time ever. And if you guys want that beautiful Trip Gaming playmat, get it on tripgaming.com right now. Let's go, baby. Locals time.
How unfortunate you didn't hit the gym today, but I did.
We just got the Locals and our beard's already being admired by the owner of Game Nation, and that is Ray. Amazing guy. Everyone who knows him knows how great of a guy he is.
even though he never lets me build my deck in peace. It always bothers me while I try to build my deck, man. It's all good. It's all good. He's my boy, but he does very annoying to build a deck around.
Okay, I have 3 minutes of safety.
We got 3 minutes in peace before we get jokingly bothered again. We got our Celine's right there. This is the deck we're trying to build. These are the cards that we're missing. So we're almost there. Yeah, as you see there, the deck's almost complete. Little by little, we will complete this deck.
Instant fusion. There we go. Just add one of these to the deck.
Just need three more Jester Confits now. Let's go, Peter! That's what I'm talking about, baby! Jester Confits, a savior. We got three Jesters now. Peter actually has a girlfriend, unlike. The only cards we're missing now are just three Magician Souls. It's when this chick comes super. I actually had no idea I came hollow. And we're almost there. The access code.
Yo, are you Trev? Pen sock.
What?
Worst deck!
What? Get your deck out right now! We'll play right now.
Geist best deck.
Geist
best deck!
Pull your cards out right now! We're gonna get the deck ready, we're gonna proxy souls, we're gonna proxy Exes Code Talker, and I'm gonna destroy this guy. Pen best deck, baby, let's go. Really, bro? Really? You're gonna challenge the pen god? Come at me, bro. Woohoo! What a great feeling to shuffle your cards, man. I don't know if you guys have shuffled your real life cards yet since COVID, but that is one of the greatest feelings of all time, bar none. Absolutely incredible feeling. Here we go. I'm playing on the beautiful Joker, Kieran, Iris playmat. You know, Thor, let's kill him properly this time. What a beautiful playmat. My opponent is playing on some Dragon Knight Weeb playmat, Pokemon or something. Who knows? But shout out to my opponent, Blake. He's from Alberta. I came to visit Game Nation, the greatest locals in the planet. Here, I know my Blue Boy and Jester, Crowley. This is just going to be an easy slap, man. I'm literally just playing the best deck. As you guys saw there, I did a cool little play where I used Blue Boy to search the card first and then Crowley. And guys, on a side note, if you guys love what you see so far in this video, let me know down in the comments what video you guys want to see next. What real-life Pendulum deck do you guys want to see me build and clap the next victim or the next challenger? I'm thinking I might build Zephyrus. Or even DDs, if you guys paid attention to me organizing my cards earlier. I am thinking about doing that. Right there, you guys see a Lullaby of Obedience. That is actually the proxied card for Magician Souls. So, as I said, I did not own a Magician Soul. I could not find it. So, that Lullaby of Obedience is a proxy for Magician Souls. That's all it is, just for the people wondering. Now, I go Daybreaker here. I expect getting bounced very soon. I summon Anima. But instead of the bounce, it does something even really good I was not expecting. He summoned out Kunkuri to negate the effect of my breaker. And that was a big problem for me because I was not expecting that. I was expecting one less of an interruption. I could have cleared the whole board. I was not expecting the Kunkuri there. Ash hurt on the knowledge. He still has the bounce on Silk. I knew it was coming right then and there. But I had to do it. I wasn't just going to pass my turn with Daybreaker and the thing. I had to hope his other set went on a trap. I was thinking it was a dead extravagance. Maybe he couldn't draw a trap or something along those lines. I don't want him to summon a Faker. At this point, I recognize that his Hextias are banished from extravagance. He used two of them. So we're in great fittings here. Even if we lose game one, I have no fear we're going to clap game two and three, but I still could win this very easily here. All I need to do, he has no Hextias. I just need to put up a Mighty Master and I basically win the duel. There I have another Magician Souls. Again, Lullaby of Obedience is a proxy for Magician Souls for the people just tuning in right now. And I'm just going to clap him right now, man. But yeah, as I was saying, hope you guys like what I'm doing today. Kind of like a vlog. If you guys like the video, just let me know. You know, like the video. Let me know in the comments if you guys like it. And I can just do more of it. I really love Yu-Gi-Oh! More than you guys can imagine. Like, it is my greatest passion of life. I can just go to being able to wake up, play Yu-Gi-Oh, go to locals. I'm truly blessed to be able to do this. So if you guys want to see more real life Yu-Gi-Oh, I got you guys. And again, for the people just tuning in right now, that Lullaby of Obedience was just a Magician Souls proxy. I don't own it. We're also proxying Axis Code Talker, which is a Ningirsu. At this point, I'm just figuring out what he's trying to do. I enter battle phase. Here I did a really stupid mistake. Sorry, not into Balbase, but I do a cool play here where I go, I make Selene with IP so it doesn't get destroyed by an effect, I believe. Or no, I try to put, no, sorry, I put, try to put too, enough cards in the graveyard. That's what I try to do. I try to put as many cards, different attributes in the graveyard for Access Code Talker, because I know the end player's Access Code. He ends up impermanent that, and it hurts so bad. I was hoping it was anything else, because if it was Mighty Master, my Mighty Master won't be able to resolve now. I end up I'm not even using Selene's effect. I just use the effect to gain counter. I use Mighty Master effect. He ends up impermanent the Selene after I use Mighty Master effect, but I just chain Selene's second effect to special the Magician Souls, which is Lullaby Obedient, just a proxy. And then again, I just summon as many attributes as possible. And then Gearsu is my proxy for Access Code Talker. I'm proxying 3 Magician Souls and 1 Access Code Talker. As then Gearsu for Access Code and the Lullaby Obedience for Magician Souls. And I use Access Code to pop as much as I can. I made a mistake earlier by attacking, leaving the Concurry, letting him actually summon it. But it's whatever. We're going to continue here. And sorry to break it to you guys, but I do end up losing game number 1. I do want you guys, I'm not going to cut any of the actual game here, game 1. I want you guys to see my misery and my loss here. It's okay, you know. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. You can't win every single game. But just how the Raptors are about to come back in game 7, and I hope this does age well. The Raptors were down 2-0, and they're going to come back. Again, I do hope this ages well. Go Raps for life. Forget the Celtics. They suck. Raps are going to the finals, baby. Raps best deck. Let's go. But just like that, you could go down a game but still come back the other two. So now I'm planning to reverse sweep, as I was hoping the Raptors would, but they obviously lost game 5, but it's all good. So we gotta lose game 1 here. We're gonna now go on to game 2, and there's just no way, bro. I'm not gonna lose to a Geist player from Alberta. Where the fuck, I'm from, where is Alberta? I don't even know, and I'm from Canada. Where is Alberta? And I'm not gonna lose some player from Alberta with a Dragonite playmat, okay? It's just impossible. Playing Altergeist, I would sooner, no, I would jump off a bridge. I will, that's just not happening. But yeah, don't jump off a bridge if you do lose, because Penn best deck and life is absolutely remarkable. So yeah, just definitely don't have any of those thoughts. Here we do, we draw our other Lullaby Obedience, aka Magician Souls. It is not, wow, I could use Lullaby for my opponent's Magician Souls. That's actually really cool. But yeah, anyways, it's just a proxy for Magician Souls. I do the same thing here. I end up opening like crazy good. Obviously, every hand's crazy good. That's another Magician Souls. I summon up restage, it seems. Keep going here. And yeah, we're just gonna plus as much as we can. I summon Jackal via Selene. Before I use the Selene, he's gonna Ghost Ogre it, which is unfortunate. I would have Jackal to protect everything, but he Ghost Ogres a Selene, which really hurt. But we're still gonna put up 5 negates through Selene, through Ghost Ogre, which is like incredible. Here, we're gonna just summon out as many cards as possible to get the most plus as possible. And yeah, this is just Pen best deck, boys. I'm gonna Pen summon as much as I could. I put counters on it now. Summon the Jackal. As you guys saw, that cool play there, where even though my Selene got Ghost Ogred, I literally still summon Selene and still summon Jackal. So through Ghost Ogre and Selene, I still put up a Selene and Jackal before my Pen summon. Nice Nibiru. So this is playing through Ogre and Nibiru like it was nothing. So Pen best deck. And I don't actually meant to summon the Chronograph there. I told him the Chronograph was never meant to be there. I end on 6 negates through Ghost Ogre. He's like, attempts extravagance. I'm like, no. He's like, okay, GG. Obviously, Pen best deck. 6 negates through Ghost Ogre. I am so good at this game. All right. Anyways, we're going to go on to game 3 now. Game 3 is going to be a dandy. He's going to go first to set up his typical trap setup. And I'm going to slowly but surely obliterate him all the way back to Kanto. And it's going to be a good one, man. It's going to be an easy clap. Pen best deck, guys. Oh my god. Just to look at my sleeves. Beautiful. And guys, as you guys see, the beautiful Joker Iris Kieran playmat. If you want to support your boy, check out the beautiful playmats on TripGaming.com. That one's not even released on TripGaming.com. So that one you have to like personally message me on Facebook if you want it. And I'll send it to you guys. But yeah, he ends up with Meloseek set 3. That clearly just means Protocol is there. That's why he didn't go Linkaribo. I put Abductor in the other zone, because last time he put Imperm in his right zone. So I don't want my Abductor to get Impermed, even though he can't get Impermed right now. But just in any scenario, maybe in retrospect, I should have put Abductor in the other way. That way my Mighty Master could resolve if he had one there. But anyways, I'm just doing my best to put as many monsters on field as possible. This is why you got to play a bunch of extenders. So I'm actually using Chronograph Effect from hand here to summon. And yeah, that what just happened there, by the way, was my phone died. So I had to use his phone. He ended up protocoling the chronograph and ended up putting another monster on field. I believe it was a normal summon. And I made Daybreaker. His, protocol, sorry about that. My phone died. We had to use his phone. So it was like 20 seconds cut off for the actual game. I tried pen summoning. Cool story here, actually. I kept telling him on the summon, like, oh, Solemn, Solemn, Solemn. And he's like, oh, he's joking, but he kept bringing up Solemn. He was like, Solemn Strike. Oh, you know, I'll strike you, I'll Solemn Judgment you. That, no, any player that has a Solemn, or any player that has a card, let's say Cosmic, they're not going to say that they have it. So clearly, if they bring up the card, they don't have it. You know what I mean? It's genius. Here's where it's a slight misplay. He put the Imperm at that zone in game one. But I purposely put it in my right zone so it doesn't get impermed. But I got a little screwed there because Abductor couldn't even got impermed because I had three spells before a monster was summoned. So I should have put the Mighty Master in my right zone. There's three, four interruptions we're playing around. We still put up lots of interruptions here. We have to enter battle phase first to clear the card. So we don't have a battle phase right now, but we put up, I don't use Mighty Master there. I have exactly six counters. I want to make sure Reflection can get an effect. And that's what we leave off here. A Selene, a Vortex, and a Reflection that could be summoned on his turn. He passes turn. So we go Mighty Master. If there's any judges in the chat here, they're not chat, any judges in the comments watching right now on YouTube, he attempts to activate a second protocol, but I just instantly negate it with Vortex. But then he attempts to use the second protocol to send the first protocol that's already face up to send the second protocol to the graveyard to negate it. But I'm like, you can't, because it's not actually face up on the field. So I'm like, you can't do it because Vortex negates the activation from even activating. But semi-judge there said, you know what? I think you could activate it. It's like emergency provision on skill drain or something along those lines, he said. I'm like, all right, man, whatever. Honestly, Penba's deck, I'll even let you have that, and I'm going to still clap. Let's go, baby. Let's go. So that was a scenario we were at there. I was like, man, whatever. I'll just give it to you. I'm pretty sure Vortex could negate it, and this first protocol cannot send the second protocol because it's not actually face up on the field because Vortex negates the actual activation of the card. But we end up just going for it. And sometimes Faker, I'm like, I'm still going to clap. I use Selene and he Ghost Ogres. I'm like, I'm still clapping. It doesn't matter. My hand is that good. I normal Abductor and activate Mastery to go for Servant. And I use Abductor Effect. It has three counters because I have another Mastery in Graveyard. Before I use Abductor Effect, he's thinking he wants to activate anything. He does it. I'm like, I don't care. I summon Jester, make Breaker, Pen Summon 3, make Access Code Attack for game.
I won, obviously. Altergeist is not going to be the best deck, okay? So for him to come in and say pen best deck, even though it's a joke, he ain't no master of the pen god. Let's go, baby!
Well, at least I'm good at Yu-Gi-Oh, all right? If you guys got the start, don't forget to smash the subscribe button. And don't forget to get the most beautiful Trip Gaming playmat on tripgaming.com. And big shout out to Ray at all of YGO Market and Game Nation. If you guys want to get all your Yu-Gi-Oh singles, get them down below. 5% off with Pen God 5. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Later, guys. Peace!